Hey guys, how's it going? Here's my video on baby gear must-haves for a small space. Three years ago, I made my very first YouTube video, and it was called Prepping for a Baby in a Small Apartment, or Prepping our Apartment for a Baby. So I thought I'd make another video considering that I'm on baby number two. I'm 38 weeks pregnant, so I apologize if I'm short of breath. I've just been having a hard time breathing because this baby is like constantly kicking me in the diaphragm. But I thought I'd put together a little video on prepping your small space for a baby. It is possible, and you can do it with, I think I've listed 8 things that I found really useful, multi-purpose, when having a baby in a small space. So number one would be a mini crib. We got our mini crib off of Wayfair. It had wheels. I'll link it in the description below, the exact one that we got. We put a bassinet in it, just like this. One of these. We used an Up a Baby bassinet in that mini crib, and it was great. We could wheel it around in and out of our bedroom. It fit nicely in the corner of our bedroom. And if in case we wanted some privacy in the bedroom, then we could wheel it out to the living room. And it also acted as a playpen since it had wheels. So we can move it around into the dining room, living room, kitchen, that sort of thing. Number two would be this, I think it's called a Raskog trolley from Ikea. We filled all 3 shelves with diapers, swaddles, burp cloths, wipes, and I had a little tray container that had like my vitamin D drops, some soothers, diaper cream, nursing pads, nail clippers, little things like that. That trolley came with me, or followed me everywhere. At night, when we needed to give baby a bath or change her, it went into the bedroom. And during the day, when I was nursing, it would follow me into the living room and be right beside me when I was nursing, watching TV. I could put my water bottle in it. It was almost like a moving coffee table. The third thing I'd say you need is a waterproof change pad. Comes in cute patterns. It's waterproof, so it's kind of that crinkly material. And that's all you need. You don't need any fancy foam. You just kind of place this on your bed or on the floor, and that's where you change baby. You change baby wherever you are in your apartment. So number four would be a bouncer. You need a safe place to put your baby down when you need both hands. We had a Mamaroo that was lent to us, and honestly, yeah, she didn't really like it. Maybe it just didn't move fast enough or it did vibrate. But my sister-in-law is lending us this one, and it's perfect. It's lightweight, very portable. Number five, a place to put your baby's clothes. In our case, we used a bookshelf from our entertainment unit. We got one of those adjustable rods. We put it on the top shelf, and that's where we hung her little dresses. And then a bunch of baskets went in the rest of the shelves, and that's where we put her pajamas, her shirts, pants, and another basket for her shoes. Number six would be a nursing pillow. Now, I didn't get a nursing pillow originally with Michaela when she was born. This is what I used, and it's just one of those skinny cushions. This time around, I did get a nursing pillow, and it's the Nook Sleep nursing pillow, and this is nice because it wraps around. But I do highly recommend a nursing pillow, especially if you're a first-time mom learning how to breastfeed. Having a nursing pillow will help with that process. Number seven is a bathtub with a sling. You can find all kinds of different bathtubs, some that fold, some that roll up, some that fit in your sink, but I think over time, as your baby grows, you will need something a little bigger. So the one that we had was this one, and it comes with a sling. So we just stored that in our bathtub, and then we'd bring it out for bath time. Unfortunately, it is kind of clunky and big. I'm sure there are other ones, but that one just worked really well for us. And my 8th baby must-have would probably be a stroller. You'll want to choose a stroller that fits in your apartment and fits in your car, that you can easily fold up, and I love the ones that just stand on their own. Now, if you don't have one that stands on its own, and you do have like a large storage space or a closet that you can store your stroller in, there are these things. This one's from Dream Baby, and it just fits over the door, and then you can hang your stroller against your door and then tuck it away. So those are my baby must-haves for the first year of life if you're living in a small space, in an apartment or a really small townhouse. If you have any questions, leave me a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you liked this video and want to see more, give it a like or subscribe to my channel. And thanks for watching. Hello! Oh, how was your nap? Was I too loud?
Yeah. You're waking me up.
Oh, did I wake you up?
No, I'm still sleepy.
You're still sleeping? Are you sleepwalking?
Huh? What's this doing up here?
Oh.